Good morning, people. It is September 28th, and I wanted to welcome you to opening day, the first vlog in our daily vlog series of the Haunted Tents Build Series. The series is going to cover taking this very empty front yard and gardens and driveway and turning it into a Halloween mystical magical retreat to bring pleasure, scares, and wet pants to many a people this year. In other words, we're getting ready to set up the haunt. Just getting out here, it's going on about 8:30 in the morning. So we're going to start getting our largest tent set up, which is going to dominate the majority of the front yard. We got a large tent that sets up right here. We've got a 10-foot tent that sets up there, over there in that corner. And then roughly right in this area here, we've got another little 10-foot tent. We're going to get set up today and start getting the part of the maze that goes underneath those tents put together. We won't get it done today, but we will get a healthy start on it, I hope. So here in a little bit, we're going to set the camera up in the tripod. We're going to give you a little bit of fast-forward footage of the tents going up. So sit tight, here we go. Okay, we've got all the parts out. The roof members for the tent are laid out kind of in the system they need to do. We got the legs over there along with the stakes to stake the tent down. The big bag has the canvas, and the pretty wife's itching to go on getting all the fittings out so we can start getting this assembled. So I'm gonna put the camera up in the tripod. Let's get us some footage. Now that the framing's done, it's time to get the tent top on. The actual canvas that goes over the top. From this camera angle, you're not going to see much but waving canvas. But I don't think you need to see me and my wife grunting and groaning while we're trying to pull the dang thing on. It takes a bit. Okay, as you saw, we got it up in the air. The third person you saw out here was my friend that built the mechs for my pneumatics for me. He stopped by to help raise it up, which was really, really good. Now I gotta go through and get the top actually attached to the frame, which takes a while, and we've got the blow up to deal with too. Well, tent's totally assembled. It's staked down, the frame's together, the top's fastened down. Next step, as you can tell, we move camera positions again, and it's aimed up at the ceiling, that black mass up there. That's the little blow-up kitty. It's our first Halloween decoration to go up. I've got to get it plugged in, and we got to get positioned and fastened down so the wind doesn't play havoc with it. Well, it took a little bit of an adjustment, but Mr. Kitty is up there. So our first Halloween decoration is officially up. Now, to me, I like the way it looks. I gotta bring my set dresser out here. She's got final say, so I may end up having to move it. Let's hope not. Well, taking a little bit of a breather. Madam set dresser is busy at the moment, so we're waiting for her to come out. And when she gets out here, we're gonna need an opinion on the big pussy up there. Speaking of Madam set dresser, I don't know if she's on camera. I wanted you to go take a look at the big pussy. I was able to hinge it around by myself, you know, using the guidelines and stuff. Kind of got it where I had. Took me twice to do it. You know, first time I kind of got there and I looked down and 1 foot was clear up in the air and had to reshuffle it. Yeah. And I got the side straps from his body going back at an angle to help hold that back end down. Was my thinking.
When the wind hits it, it's not
going to
flip over.
Yeah, well, I know we had one last time we had him up there. The wind was getting so strong. The back end, he was actually kissing his own ass a couple of times. So, but did that look okay to you?
Tag on the end.
Yeah.
You know, his butt end.
Yeah. But there's nothing. Yeah, there's nothing to tie it to back there, unfortunately. Okay. The mighty set dresser says,
it looks fine.
Hey, I don't have to redo it. Next stage on the whole thing is pop-ups. I've got a 10 by 10 tent that runs off here, and I've got another 10 by 10 tent over there that goes up next to that bush, which is where the witch's display is gonna be this year. And I've got the set dresser out here. She's going through all our tie down straps and using zip ties, I should say, to zip tie the buckle shut so people can't open them and take the straps loose. Then she's also gonna be getting in here, if you notice, all the white straps here, and they're all the way around the outside of the tent. That's what's holding the tent top to the frame. She's gonna get up here and get these all tucked into place so they're hidden and out of the way. So I'm gonna get you a little bit more tent setting upping for today's footage. Okay, second tent done. Time for the third. okie dokie, and I started it out with okay. I gotta stop using that word so much. But as you can see, we got one of the tents up here. We got the big tent up, and we've got this one up over here. It's staked down, both this tent and that tent, so they're good to go. Now, this is only a portion. I still got four more tents to put up, but they're going on the driveway. I've got two tents that run from this one all the way over to here, and which is going to be graveyard, chain hall, and the exit. Then I've got two more tents that will go roughly right about where my truck is sitting, which is going to house a spider display. And in between here and here will be graveyard. And as with every year, those will go up probably in about a week, week and a half. Reason being, I need access to my trailer and, you know, a couple other things. I gotta be able to get the car in and out of the driveway and stuff. And I can't do that once the tents go up. But for right now, we are going to be focusing on here with this tent, the big tent, the small tent. My next chore is I have some canvas sidewalls I'm going to put up that run here, down, and across the front. And, you know, I do partition walls and stuff along there. You know, once they're up and skinned, no one can see in. But I like to keep things kind of secretive. You know, I don't really want people knowing what I'm doing until we're actually open. So I'm going to go out and get my canvas sidewalls, and we'll put them up in here to kind of block view. That's the last major tent thing for today I need to do, is those canvas sidewalls. Then we can actually start putting some walls up. Well, we got you back in the garden, right where you started out at. And as you can see, those two long white things laying on the ground, those are my sidewalls. Got to get those attached to the tent. Well, with that, I have a little bit of privacy. Now, this side wall here will be coming down because I'm going to have skins on both sides of the partition walls that go up. And I'm not sure about that one. That one we normally leave up year-round all the way through the season. But if I have enough extra skins, I might skin the outside partition walls too, and we'll just take that tarp all the way down. I don't know. We haven't gotten that far yet, but we'll see. So, right now, next thing on my bucket list is get some lunch or breakfast or whichever. I've been up since 7. I haven't eaten, and it's afternoon now. I'm hungry. But our next project, our next step in the process is I got to get my table out here, my tools out here, and then we've got all the partition walls. We got to start bringing those out and doing various stacks of them throughout the tent, so I'm not having to run after them all the time. And then we're going to actually start getting some partitions up, which is kind of new for us. Seems like about every year, by the time I get done with work and we get home, I have enough time first day to get the 3 or 4 basic tents up out here on the lawn. And by the time I get to this point, I'm beat and it's late, so we call it quits. And then the next day we start messing with partition walls. This year, however, got a good night's sleep last night. We got an early start. So I'm actually going to get, on day one, we'll actually get some partition walls up. I'll have a nice lunch. Took a little bit of time just to sit and kind of relax. And did a little bit of research. When we were over at Troy's doing the bonfire, I was mentioning about my neighbor who does a zombie haunt. And Troy wanted to visit some other haunts. So I went and got the web address off their sign and went and looked it up. Sure enough, they're open during the time Troy's here, with one exception. They're open Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Troy's coming over middle of the week. And they aren't open. So, don't know. I'll have to work with Troy on that. I think most of the haunts here are like that. They're open on the weekends only. So, Anyway, with that being said, we're back out here. You notice I got one stack out and gone. Those will stay there until I need them. I'll just bring them out one stack at a time for now. And that stack that's missing is sitting right here. I've also got my tool table out here with my screws and my bucket for carrying everything and my maps. Now I've showed you, get the right page up, this one here, and that's my tent layout. It tells me where all the tents are gonna go. And then this one here shows where all my partition walls go. Now some of my maze is done with the partition walls, but it's also done with the wrought iron fencing. This is not showing the wrought iron fencing. It's just showing the placements of all the partition walls. And the first area we're gonna be working on is right here, this room here. And that is underneath the big tent. You notice it doesn't look like it has much, just panels around the outside and a little one right here. That's because most of this year is going to be pond. We are doing a couple of big ponds in here this year. So we're gonna be getting started putting up those panels right in through here. We're gonna start going down from this corner here and working our way around getting all these panels up. And if I make it burn through all of those, which I probably will, I'll get the next stack out. Okay, I screwed up, in a way. I forgot a step. I got my roofing material that I put in. Helps make things a little bit more claustrophobic. So that was supposed to go in before I start putting partition walls up. And my drill ran out of juice on this last panel. So I'm gonna finish getting that panel up and then I'm gonna switch over and get the roof in. And then we'll get back to partition walls. Okay, got the three ceilings up. You didn't see this because these were off camera. You can get footage of this, but it's nothing really big. You saw me put up the big one, and you know what's what with that. Now, last year, when we had this set up, this hole was over there because I had the fogger sitting right now. I didn't want the fogger sitting on top of the netting, so I cut a hole in it. I'm going to have to get a piece out and kind of patch that, because it's going to end up being right in the middle of the aisleway. But you also saw my helpers came out. Surprised me, I wasn't expecting it. And they brought out two more stacks. You saw them bringing them out and putting them in here. I can use them, that's definitely sure. But anyway, now that we got the ceilings back up, it's time to get back to doing the partition walls. I gotta use up some of these free panels I got. Now that the roof panels are done, I can get back to putting partition walls up. And the wife is being nice, and she's got some energy, which is a surprise. So she's bringing out the skins for the water room and the torture room, which go in underneath that big tent for me. And what I'm going to do is, once I get all the partition walls up in that area, I'm going to go back through and get them skinned. So it'll be nice having them out here. Okay, sorry about that. I turned the camera off to take a break about an hour and a half ago. Forgot to turn the camera back on. There's been some changes in here since the last clip. And we officially have all the partition walls up for both the torture chamber, which is going to be over here in this bump out. We're going to have a 3-foot aisleway here, so all that will be for the torture chamber. And then this monstrosity here is going to be for the water wall. And the water wall will attach to the front of it here with the fan blade in the back. So it's going to be interesting. And then this all out here in the center will be pond, and we'll do a zigzag pattern. So they'll come out there and kind of walk a zigzag through here. But we got this all set up. Now, normally, I would just keep putting up partition walls. But this year, I'm doing a little bit different. As you notice, my wife and daughter brought out the skins. I got these for the water room and those for the torture chamber. So I am going to go ahead, and before we do anything else out here with the partition walls, I'm going to get this area totally skinned, and then I think I'm going to do it display by display this year. I'll get the partition walls up, get it skinned, you know, and just keep kind of going like that. You know, for the displays I have skins for, I've got, the chain hall and the pirate display that are scene setters. So those probably won't get skinned, but I'll get the walls up in those areas. But we made some good progress today, you know, with all the partition walls up. And we got this tent, that tent, and the big tent up. And then we even got one of the blow-ups going. So it's pretty good up there. And it's been getting attention by the kids walking home from school already. So they know, all the local kids that walk by here know what's going on when the tent and the blow-up goes up. So everyone's excited. I've had a couple of adults stop by asking about hours and stuff already. But it's almost dinner time. I'm going to go ahead and put the camera back in the tripod and start doing some skinning out here. And I'm going to work until dinner time. And then I'm going to call it kind of quits early. We got an early start out here this morning, and it's father-daughter time tonight. I have no idea how long this vlog has ended up being, because I haven't edited it yet. So let's get you a little bit more footage. Probably won't be much more footage, but I started putting up some skins. I don't know how much footage I got of it. I forgot to turn the camera on a couple of times. But I just got done with dinner. I'm calling it quits. It's almost 8 o'clock and it's father-daughter time out. It's all on Monday night. So I'm going to go in and spend some time with my daughter instead of dragging a light around. But we did pretty good out here. We got the partition walls up in here, which I showed you earlier. And I started with this pattern here on the skins. This is the sewer room panels. And you'll notice from last year that these have been calmed down a little bit. I got that wall done. So tomorrow we're going to get out here and we're going to get the rest of the skins on on everything that's in this tent, and get it done, and then we'll work back more on put more partition walls up. I don't know if I'm going to do this section first, which is going to be the gypsy room, or start over there in that corner, which is the witch's display. I might get both done. I don't know. I don't know how far we're going to get. I did want to give you one other thing too, and I don't know if it's going to show up on this camera, but yeah, it does. The little kitty at night lights up there, and he's been catching a lot of attention. But we haven't been doing too bad today. I think I said in an earlier clip, normally, first day of the build, all we get up is usually the tents and the ceiling material, and then the side, canvas walls. So today, we're actually way ahead of schedule. We've gotten a lot done. Now also, during dinner, I got a comment on my, blowout video, the last get together over at Troy's for the season, from Halloweenville, and he reminded me of something that we did last year, the Breakfast Club, and the donut of the day. I had totally spaced that out. And I think we're going to try that again this year. problem is, I gotta remember my donuts, which is fun. Or biscuits. We could do muffins. We could do tea or coffee. But breakfast club of the month, or I guess for this month. And I normally give that out at the beginning of the vlog, but since I forgot, we're gonna do it at the end of the vlog. Apple fritters, boys and girls. Today's donut is apple fritters. So go grab you one, stick it in the microwave for about 20 seconds, warm it up, have a cup of coffee, and then enjoy the rest of your day. With that, I'm going to bring this vlog to a close. I have a feeling it's going to be long, and I'll find out as soon as I start editing it. So I'm going to shut the heck up and just say, stay spooky, stay toxic on day one.